No, in a bit.
Catholic and Protestant children from Belfast returning from a holiday in Wales. Their first break away from the troubles of Ulster.
Right, smile.
One for me, you can't catch me. Two for me, you'll never get me. Three for me, you can't catch me. Four for me, you'll never get me.
Joe lives off the old Park Road, an IRA battleground littered with the shells of empty houses, which can provide snipers with cover in their war against the British Army.
Go for a bullet. Ah, let's see you do it. Right. Hey, bullets! Where you find them? You
get me? I seen a tin of mine. I wouldn't bat them up. Watch it.
The walls have been knocked through so snipers can shoot and make their getaway. In Belfast, children play in the shadow of the army. Catholics and Protestants live in separate areas. Each area has its religious frontier and each frontier its army post. Joe's hobby is his pigeon.
Do you like animals, Joe?
Yes.
What kind of animals?
Pigeons. Bulls.
What do you do all day when you play around here, Joe?
Sometimes just feeding pigeons, and sometimes just playing the old houses. And look for bullets sometimes.
Do any Protestants live around here?
Over there, and over there. And up there.
Do you have any Protestant friends?
No.
None at all?
No.
Would you like any Protestant friends?
No.
Brian lives in Sandy Row, and Sandy Row is Loyalist country, where William of Orange is still king. Brian spends most of his time playing in a disused railway cutting. A few hundred yards down the line is where the Catholic children play. Brian's favourite diversion is bee bashing.
What are you doing, Brian?
I'm hitting bees. It's their bitter thing that they call rhubarb.
Can't you see any?
Nah, they must be all the way in some other plants. We see our plants, the bees go in them are sort of like wee shells and they get some sort of honey or something.
Why do you hit them?
Because I was down here walking along the railway tracks and one came and stung me.
Do you like animals?
Yes, I've got a hamster. And its name's Hammy.
Do you have any Catholic friends?
No.
Why not?
I don't know. I never meet any. Have we meet any, I run.
You run?
There's a grasshopper. It's a black grasshopper.
Why do you run if you meet any Catholics?
I don't like them. I've met them, but they run after you and they chase you, you know. If they catch you, they hit you.
Why do they hit you?
I don't like Protestants.
Would you like to have any Catholic friends?
They'd be all right. There's a bee there. Yeah, there's four different kinds of bees you can get. There's a worker, there's a queen, there's another one that's sort of whitish colour, and there's a orange bottom bee. There's another one.
Joseph is from the Short Strand area of East Belfast, a small Catholic enclave surrounded by Protestants. He lives right on the peace line where the two communities meet. Most of his neighbours have fled. The only other faces in the street belong to the army. Joseph's old house was blown up.
This used to be my house. That is the bedroom up there where I slept with my brother on bunk beds. It was all carpeted, and there was nicely coloured flowers on the wallpaper. There was a wardrobe facing the wall that was most damaged in the explosion, and it stopped it from completely caving in. Used to be a good house, but it isn't anymore. In this area there itself, it's all Catholic. There isn't. We're all like an island surrounded, and it's this part's all Catholic. You can't go anywhere in the Protestant areas. You can't go to Victoria Park or the Armo like we used to before the trouble started, and now you can't go anywhere. Just you must stay in the area.
Do you have any Protestant friends?
No. It would be too dangerous having Protestant friends. You couldn't play them or do anything.
John is a Protestant. He's 13. He lives on the edge of Belfast in Liganeel, which has suffered almost as much as the centre of the city. John's first love is fishing.
I love fishing. Waking up in the mornings, early. In the morning, get up at 7:30, go fishing. Only caught two little ones. Threw them back into the dam again. It's really great. One time when I was up fishing, I was up at the dam and a bomb went up. And I went up in the air, came down again. It was a big bomb. It was just behind me in the mill. Blew me off my feet. I was walking past, coming down, and the second bomb went off. Destroyed the mill. I was frightened. Didn't know what to do. The rod just fell out of my heart. A bit rod sometimes is good. At the end of the year is the best time to use a bit rod. When the water is really flowing fast and mucky. And when it's dull. I never think of the troubles when I'm fishing. It's the only thing I takes my mind off the troubles. When I'm fishing, I hear shooting plenty of times. When I'm up at the dam, I hear a whole lot of guns. Thompson machine gun, soldiers, SLR, Sterling, snipers, pistols, all those kind of guns. When you've been living in Belfast like me, you get plenty of practice of listening.
And so the group came together, 12 children, Catholics and Protestants, from the troubled areas of Belfast. But they were not pioneers. This summer, 8,000 children left Northern Ireland on mixed holidays organised by the Community Relations Commission. This group's holiday was paid for by the Round Table organisation of North Kent.
Hello. And Joseph.
The group came together cautiously at first, under the eyes of the two volunteers, instinctively dividing up on the quayside into Catholics and Protestants.
What's your name?
Joseph.
Joseph, this is Joseph, and you're going to put in touch him. What part of, where do you come from?
From down Short Strand area.
Down Short Strand. Everybody here?
These children live, play and go to school with children of their own religion. They had never met each other before. The aim of these holidays is not just to give a break from the troubles, but to bring together children who have never before crossed the religious barriers of Belfast.
When we're at the quayside, you know, in the boat getting a mara told us, we weren't worried then. Except, you know, we're curious to know where we came from. You know, when you know, when a person tells you where you come from, you immediately, you know, what religion he is.
Most of these children were leaving Belfast for the first time. Most of them could scarcely remember a Belfast free from fighting.
Have you got 10 pence to spend? Well, then I'll keep this and then you can get so much a day.
Take care, Smore.
Yo!
They were leaving behind them the stories and songs that have fed the prejudice of Catholic and Protestant for 300 years, a mythology where men fight and die for Ireland, but under two different flags.
One Friday morning, when the war was over, the battlefield was shed with blood, and there I saw a wounded soldier lying dying as he says, God bless my home and dear old Ireland. God bless my wife and children three. God bless the flag that I lie under, the Union Jack, red, white and blue. My only son was shot in Dublin, fighting for his country bone. He fought for Ireland and for Ireland only. The harp and shamrock, green, white and gold.
Butlins Holiday Camp, North Wales, was their destination, where life was different and everything free.
Here, when you're walking about at night, there's nobody about the streets. That gunmen like running about the streets that would shoot you. But over in Belfast, you're scared. Somebody run down the street with a gun, just open fire. You're scared of that.
When you're walking around, say England, you don't get stopped, searched, or well. Ask what religion you're of that.
Joe, look at his claws, Joe. Yeah. Look at his claws and his teeth.
Look at his claws.
Imagine the hamster had them.
Eyes out so good.
What?
You pick your eyes out.
Have a little nibble. He's out of the bed, though. Sit in his tail.
see how deep it is.
Do you find it very different being over here, Joe?
Well, you can go anywhere without getting beat up or, you know, ask your religion or anything. It's just quieter, there's no trouble or, you know, shooting or anything like that.
Did you expect it to be like this over here?
Yeah. It's like the Garden of Eden. No, just forget about Belfast. You can stay where it is.
Have you talked about religion with the other children? Yeah.
No, it hasn't been mentioned. We don't care about our religion. See, so over here, we're all friends, so we'll play about. So what's the use of mentioning religion?
You don't regard each other as Catholics and Protestants?
Sure, it doesn't matter. You're still people, so what's the use of worrying about your religion? If you can play together, well, so play together. So your religion's got nothing to do with it. It's only a different church you go to, so it doesn't matter.
Could you have done this in Belfast?
No. And no, you couldn't play with anyone of your different religion because you could either get beat up on your own side, you know, for playing with a boy of a different religion, or if you want to play in Missouri, you could get beat up then, so it's not worth the risk.
Has anything ever happened to you in Belfast?
Yeah, you can get shot. I was shot there when it was the Holy Day of Obligation, and I went down and I was standing just a wee bit down from it, and all of a sudden, gunfire broke out in the morning. He started shouting, to all the women and children. He shouted, get up to your houses before anyone gets hurt. And then I just, was walking away and the bullet hit the ground, it ricocheted up and took a leg into me and got me. And then once it went through, and after I realised it went through a woman's dress. So one was lucky and I wasn't. And then I got taken to the hospital and there were priests and everything around me and thought I was going to die. But then the doctor saved me, the surgeon, and he said, I'll live to 100. I was that lucky. Because if it had went an inch, 2 inches lower, it could have been dead. And an inch higher, could have been dead too, or blind, or no nose.
What do you want to do when you leave school, Jo?
I'd like to be a film photographer. It'd be good. It's easy. Just turn my camera and look through. Big house. Go over to America.
You won't stay in Belfast?
No. Who wants to? If you've got money, well, you can get out of it. You're paying for troubles in Belfast. You're paying your rent, so you're paying for troubles. So go over to America or anywhere except Belfast.
It's been different. There's been no shooting or no bombing. No gangs running about the streets or anything. You can hear nothing here.
In our district, a while ago, there was shooting. The 10th of July it was. There was terrible shooting, so it was. Then there was a fella killed, shot dead. Get riddled by the soldiers starting. That morning I got up and I seen all the blood. It was terrible, so it was. Really sick. Sick. Everybody couldn't look at it. It was on the walls, the hand marks on the wall. It's still on the wall, so it is. Hand mark of where he fell.
Look at a helicopter.
What? So this, that helicopter again.
Will you keep in touch when you go back to Belfast?
I don't know his address and he doesn't know my address.
You could find it out quite easily, couldn't you?
How would he might tell me his address and I might tell him my address?
Tell him, Brian.
I'm 34 years old, Street Sandy Row. 1982 Ardley Street. Old Park Road. 1982 Ardley Street, Old Park Road. Such anyway, he might be able, for all you know the writing, he might, I might be able to read it.
How is it different going to bed over here than going to bed at night in Belfast?
I want to go to bed over there. All you hear is the shooting and all starting and the bombing. And then the night it's all quiet. And over there you hear the birds and all. You hear the birds.
You can hear birds over here. You can hear birds over here, but you can't hear squirrels over in Belfast.
Mm-hmm. Will you see the other children of the other religion when you go back to Belfast?
No, not at all. When I go home, it'll be the last time I'll see them.
What do you feel about not seeing your new friends again?
You have to accept it, but I'd like to play with them, you know, but I can't. It's only here. We'll have a great time here.
How will you keep in touch with each other when you go back to Belfast?
I don't think we can. Unless we write a letter, maybe.
Get each other's address. Write letters. Make a pen pal. You could make a pen pal with them.
Isn't that a bit strange, having pen pals in your own city?
Yeah. Very strange.
Doesn't matter.
But you can't get them any other way, you see.
Wouldn't be able to see
only
them.
By phone or else by letter.
How do you feel about going back to Belfast now?
Well, you have to go back, but I don't mind. I'd love to stay here, but I can't, so I must go back and face it all.